Hi, very good morning. I'm Dr. Janak Patel, MD, General Physician. Today we'll be discussing on one of the interesting topic which comes in CBC, that is leukemoid reaction. The meaning is very simple. Leukeme is leukemia, and oid means similar, like. So it is called leukemoid reaction. It is like leukemia, but it is not leukemia. Good number of time you will see such reports. You should be able to pick up this. It is also called as a myeloid leukemoid reaction because majority of the time it is a myeloid series. So being a myeloid series, it is called as a myeloid leukemoid reaction. We'll be discussing under these three headings, that is definition, etiology, and how you differentiate from leukemia, particularly chronic myeloid leukemia, which is very close differential diagnosis of leukemoid reaction. So, leuko means leukemia, moid means like. So, it is leukemoid reaction. So, it is exaggerated leukocyte response against a microbial pathogen, that is some of the infections, or even to a sudden stress where your WBC count is more than 50,000. It can be myeloid series or it can be lymphoid series. By and large, it is a myeloid series, but it can be lymphoid series also. So it is called myeloid leukemoid reaction, that is leukemia plus oid, that is looking like. That's why it is called looking like leukemia. The count is more than 50,000. The normal count of WBC is 4 to 11,000. Now neutrophil series, that is you get leukocytosis of neutrophil series with a shift to the left. Meaning shift to the left means you start getting little immature cells in peripheral smear, and they are also increased in bone marrow, immature cells, but they are not blast cells. When you get blast cells, we call that as acute leukemia. Now as far as the etiology is concerned, the most common etiology is infections. Among infection, endocarditis, pneumonia, septicemia, leptospirosis will give rise to myelocytic series, while pertussis, tuberculosis, varicella, infectious mononucleosis can give rise to lymphocytic series, and in tuberculosis you will get monocytic series. In case of a toxic condition like eclampsia, mercury poisoning, extensive burns, you will get more of myelocytic series. In CA colon, kidney, neoplasia, you will get again myelocytic, and in CA breast and stomach, you will get lymphocytic series. In acute hemorrhage and acute hemolysis, again myelocytic series may be elevated, while in case of a skin disorders called dermatitis, herpetiformis, you will have more of lymphocytic. These are some of the common conditions. There are many more conditions. Among infection, Clostridium difficilis, shigellosis, disseminated tuberculosis, serious bacterial infections, etc., accounts for one of the most common cause for leukemoid response, or we call reaction. Severe burns, certain malignancy, and massive blood loss, massive hemorrhage. As far as malignancy is concerned, lung carcinoma, oropharyngeal, GI tract, genitourinary tract, Hodgkin's lymphoma, sarcoma, melanoma, etc. Among drugs, corticosteroids, recombinant hematopoietic growth factor, ethylene glycol, minocycline, etc. To differentiate between CML and leukemoid reaction, Age, as far as CML is concerned, always more than 40 years of age. You will never see in an early age group. While leukemoid, you can see at any age. Usually, this is in lakhs, or we call 100,000. This will be 50,000. Usually, we say that more than 50,000, but usually, leukocytosis, we consider between 30 to 50,000, you can suspect leukemoid reaction. You will see basophil as well as eosinophil in CML, but it is usually not seen in leukemoid. Splenomegaly is a common feature in CML. It is not seen in leukemoid. Philadelphia chromosome is present in CML. It is always absent in case of leukemoid reaction. We call leukocyte alkaline phosphatase, and neutrophil alkaline phosphatase will be very, very low or usually absent, quite frequently absent in CML, but it will be high in case of leukemoid response. CML can be transformed into acute leukemia, like acute myeloid leukemia, but this leukemoid response or reaction does not get transformed into acute leukemia. CML is basically a neoplasm, or we call malignancy. Usually you come across asymptomatic person, or sometimes they come with fever, weight loss, malaise, and massive splenomegaly. And peripheral smear may show basophil or eosinophil. While in leukemoid response, it is a reactive process. It is not a malignancy. Good number of time, the person has got infective sepsis as a common cause of leukemoid response. So they are severely or critically ill patient. And peripheral smear does not show eosinophilia or basophilia. We call LAP score is increased in case of leukemoid, but it is usually low or absent. Toxic granules are commonly seen in leukemoid response. It is not commonly seen in CML. Doll's body are present in leukemoid response. It is absent in case of CML. And we already mentioned Philadelphia chromosome is present in CML. It is absent in case of leukemoid response. And our bodies will be present in case of what we called as chronic lymphatic leukemia, but it is not present in case of leukemoid response or reaction. So these are the peripheral smear. WBC count will be more than 50,000 in leukemoid. It will be more than lakhs in CML. There will be shift to the left, means you will have a myelocytes and blast cells may be present 5%, while here usually blast cells are more than 30%. Myelocyte neutrophil peak will be absent, while this will be present in case of a chronic myeloid leukemia. Toxic granules are increased in leukemoid, which are not present commonly in case of CML. Anemia is mild, while in case of CML, it is present and progressive. Eosinophil and basophil are present in case of CML, but they are usually low in case of leukemoid response. Platelets are usually normal while they are increased in case of CML. Bone marrow will be hyperplasia, but mild, while here there will be hypercellular bone marrow and there will be a lot of immature cells. This is a slide which tells you regarding what will be present in case of a acute leukemia. That is acute myeloid leukemia, you will have all rods. While here, in case of acute lymphatic leukemia, you will have a blast cells which will be present. And you will have anemia and leukocytosis which will be present in both acute variety of leukemia. So anemia, leukocytosis and thrombocytopenia is a common feature which will be present in an acute leukemia. But our bodies, our rods will be a common feature in this. While here, you will have a Philadelphia chromosomes which will be present in CM. So in a chronic, in CML, you will have a Philadelphia chromosomes. In this, you will have a beta cells which will be abnormal. So these are different types of cells which you can see, which will be seen in a peripheral smear and in a bone marrow. In acute leukemia, you will see more of a blast cells. While in case of a chronic leukemia, you will see the number of blast cells will be relatively less. And in case of a what we call as leukemoid response, you will see more of a band cells, metamyelocytes, myelocytes, and blast cells may be seen, but they are less than 5%. As far as management is concerned, always keep calm, try to identify the etiology and treat the underlying cause. As soon as you start treating the underlying cause, person will be normal and your count will also come back to normal. So I thank you all for taking out time. I know that your time is valuable and I appreciate that for you to you are spending some of the time with me. I feel this will be very helpful because sometime you will see the WBC report. WBC is 60,000, 70,000. Person is having high-grade fever. There is some signs of infection. But in a peripheral smear, there are no abnormal cells. Good number of time it is misdiagnosed as leukemia. So always keep a watch. Always differentiate from chronic myeloid leukemia. And try to identify the etiology. You treat the etiology, person will be recovering and person will show a good response. If you like this video, please press button like and subscribe and also share with your friends because this will be very helpful in your everyday practice as well as in your exams. All these videos, lectures are for educative purpose. So I end my lecture here. I hope this will be very helpful to you.